about It's a Woman's World. But there are four conditions that make it so. And as I say, these have come about by accident, not by design. Now, the first one is that we are living in the world in a matriarchal society. Now, lots of people are surprised by this, but the definition of a matriarchal society is that the culture and values and norms of each of our cultures are passed down through the female line. That is the definition of what makes it a matriarchal society. Now here we see the accident that has happened, because men have tended to be absent in the families. But even when research has been done, men who think that they're involved with their children are actually only doing the fun aspect, I'm daddy, your playmate, rather than the actual work of raising children. So men see their job in terms of being a father. They see their job to be the child's playmate, the fun aspect of the relationship. While mothers do the disciplining, they do the cooking and the cleaning and all the hard work that goes with it. Men are often absent, certainly in the Western world, due to divorce. And men can generally, because of career demands, etc., are far more absent in the home than women are when it comes to interacting with the children. Now, just on a kind of a fun television program, one of these chat show programs was an American program, and a man said that he does equal amount of work at home. So he was challenged. They said, okay, to the woman, you write down every single thing you do in terms of free labor in the home. And you write down to the man every single thing that you do in terms of free labor in the home. And the man, who thought he was really involved, was a 50-50 as far as he was concerned, came back the next week with one page. And the woman had reams and reams and reams and reams of paper in terms of what she had been doing, an average day or in an average week. So when we're looking at it being a matriarchal society, today women have far more influence in terms of the amount of time over children than men do, because women are much more involved with children. So we're teaching our children feminine values by accident more than by design. And we can cause and effect enormous amount of change in the way that we raise boys and the way that we raise girls. Because certainly in my culture, women are taught, little girls are taught that you can climb trees and you can play with motorcycles, you can do anything that a boy can do. And boys are being encouraged to bring out the softer, gentler, the compassionate side that you were talking about. Their parents are giving them dolls to play with. But what is happening emotionally is that we are still being raised into the same roles. That women are raised to take on the emotional job of a family, and boys are still emotionally being prepared to be the provider and the protector. So the things may look different in terms of what we are doing with our children, but because we've raised children the way we were raised ourselves, then we tend to pass that legacy on, the subconscious emotional legacy that we've all gained from our culture. Now, the second one that is making it a woman's world is what we call the blurring of roles. Roles 100 years ago were really clearly defined. Women stayed at home, 150 years ago certainly, and they did the household and men went on to work. Very clearly defined. Today, we have female chemical engineers. We have male fashion models. So because of this blurring of roles, nothing is as clear cut as it used to be. That we're learning different things. We're learning different skills in terms of the roles that we're expected to live. The third one is our changing world of work. But all the research is showing that everywhere around the world, how we work is very different from how we used to work 30, 40 years ago. 30, 40 years ago, we'd go to an office, and we'd be employed, a lot of jobs. We'd get a job for life, guaranteed pension, or fund thereafter so we could live thereafter. Today it's estimated that when it comes to the big corporate companies, that between 30 to 50% of people worldwide within the next 3 to 5 years will be technically unemployed. Now that doesn't mean we'll never work again, that would be absurd. But we've got technology has made it possible for us to work anywhere in the world. We can work from home, we can work as an outsourced business, we can work on a beach somewhere while we're on holiday because of the technology that makes it possible. Now this outsourcing is a boon for women because one of the biggest reasons that women leave corporate jobs is because of the lack of work as our third condition, which is setting the stage for women to have far more opportunity because then we can choose our working hours. We're also looking at structures like participative management. Participative management has simply come about because women have entered businesses in their droves. The old school style of male businesses is that the boss sits at the top of the building, right? And the hierarchy moves down from there. So as soon as women started entering businesses in their droves, we have new styles of management, one of them being participative. We have concepts like emotional intelligence coming out of the Western world saying, hang on a sec, this is all part of being human. Now these three conditions are setting the stage for women to be able to thrive like never before. And the fourth one is the growing economic power of women. There are writers like Tom Peters who talk about that in the world, the biggest economy is run and managed by women. And women, American women, control whether they're employed or whether they are working in their own businesses, which lots have done because of the lack of flexible working hours. But American women control more money as a collective group than any other single economy around the world.